Welcome to my channel, Stories by Leia. I'm Leia. I am a creative producer in the documentary industry, and I am here to share with you the top five best underrated free apps that I use as a creative producer. So I think this is especially helpful for beginners, but also seasoned professionals. And this doesn't only apply to producers, also if you're a director, editor, just filmmaker in general, these are apps that you are going to love. So let's get into it. Number one, Clockify. I love Clockify. How is this free? I'm not sure, but I love it. It is a time tracking tool. So if you are tracking your time for anything, even just like as a freelancer, as a creative, there's so many different projects that we touch. I love Clockify because you can break down things per project, per client, and it's just an ongoing timer. Like you basically log on there, you press play, you can do whatever client, whatever project, you can have even different tasks, and you get data on yourself. You're able to see, oh, like how long did that project actually take me? Or, oh wow, like I was complaining about editing this one video, but it only took me an hour. And also you can invite other team members to it. So I have, you know, my business partner, Matt, he doesn't really like to do it all the time, but I try to tell him to do that. When I've had interns, I have them do it. It's just a great accountability, productivity tool, I would say. And I find that because I use it, when I'm on the clock, I really am focusing on that one thing. So Clockify is a lifesaver. I use it every day. They have a desktop version. I normally use it on my desktop, but they also have one on your phone as well. Please download Clockify, get in control of your schedule, make better quotes, get data on yourself. I can't talk about Clockify enough because I love it and I think everyone could use something like this. Gone are the days of your ugly, poorly lit iPhone photos of crumpled receipts and documents. Adobe Scan is your new best friend. The mobile app is so freaking easy to use. You can directly email yourself. I'm pretty sure you can even save it to Google Drive from there. I always email myself receipts and it's super easy. Number three, Temi. This is a transcription service. So you can take an interview, a phone call, whatever, and translate that into a transcript of words, text transcript. So maybe you've heard of Rev.com. They're a super popular transcription service, and I think they do translations as well, but they're pretty pricey. So that's where Temi comes in. It's a cute little brother that is way less expensive. Your first transcription is free, I think up to an hour. So you upload an audio file, or I think you could also do a video file, but I would recommend just doing like an MP3, and they will do it completely for free. So, you know, you should use all your different email addresses. Once that runs out, it's 25 cents per minute, which in comparison, on Rev.com, that is $1.25 per minute. Now that's because at Rev, they employ humans, and at Temi, they employ robots. They use AI completely, and that's why it's cheaper. But I find that it's pretty accurate. Yes, sometimes it's not the best, but like it gets the job done, right? For way cheaper. And it's faster, I think, too. I use this for every documentary, every branded film that I work on, because it helps me find the best sound bites, it helps me create a story structure, and I personally like it because I'm a writer, and so I like to see the story structure on paper first, what I like to call a paper cut, and I use that as a direction when I'm working with different editors, when I'm directing a piece, or even producing or creative directing. I always use transcriptions, and they're super helpful in formulating the story that you want to tell. Do you ever find yourself working super late and you have an email, you want to send it, but you're like, maybe they're normal humans and they work 9 to 5 instead of us crazy freelancers and filmmakers. Maybe I should send this email during normal business hours. This is where Boomerang comes in. So this is a free extension on Gmail that you can install super easy, basically like a couple clicks, and you can schedule your emails. I think there's a couple of other features, but I personally just use it to schedule emails. Another feature I really like is it nudges you. It kind of puts it at the top of your inbox when somebody hasn't responded. So it'll say something like, oh, you sent it 5 days ago. They haven't replied. Wanna follow up? I really like that feature as well. This is really helpful as a producer, communicating to lots of different people, sometimes across different time zones, and also working with corporate clients who work normal 9 to 5 jobs, and you don't want to disturb them on off hours. Number 5, PhotoScan. Again, a completely free app that turns your phone, kind of similar to Adobe Scan, but instead of documents or receipts, it scans photos. So let's say you're filming your character looking through some old photos and you're like, oh, this would be really dope if I scan this. Oh, like I don't have a scanner, my character doesn't have a scanner. I can't trust that. Like, oh, I guess the footage is just fine. No. Instead, you use PhotoScan. It takes less than a minute to scan a photo. It doesn't even have to be in the best lighting. It could be on any background. Like, I don't know how it does it, but it is amazing and it impresses me every time. I use it for my short documentary, One Pamilia, with all my family photos in the Philippines. I use this all the time and I've never had issues with it. It always comes back with a high quality JPEG that I can toss into any film. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. I hope you gained some knowledge. If you did, drop me a like, hit that subscribe, leave a comment, tell me what app you're most excited to use, or if there's an app that you have that nobody knows about, tell us, and don't be a stranger. Say hi, let's continue to build this community of badass documentary producers, and yeah, until next time, peace out. Tangible and tactical, is tactical a word? I don't know. Amazing. Start over. Don't be a strange doll.